Sardegna, Costa Smeralda,
Sardegna, Emerald Coast, Cugnana Gulf, Marina Cala de Sardi. Marina Cala de Sardi is a little gem right in the middle of Cugnana Gulf, between Marina di Portisco and Porto Rotondo, in the northeast side of Sardinia.
Siamo venuti qui per
We are here to film an Io Navigo lesson, the sailing lesson of SVN Solo Velanet. An important lesson because it's about mooring, stern to mooring, the Mediterranean system to moor a boat.
Per realizzare questo video,
to do it, we needed help of many people and several boats, and we got it from North Sardinia Sail, one of the biggest charter companies in Italy, with almost 100 boats, and for this we want to thank them.
Quindi li ringraziamo.
And now let's go to see the lesson.
Quando parliamo di ormeggio,
when talking about mooring, there are a few distinctions to take in account. First of all, we must consider the wind, because there is a quite difference between a mooring on a windy and a non-windy day. Also, the type of boat is very important. The maneuver change if we are on an SO-drive boat or on a drive shaft boat. In this lesson, we will see how to moor both type of boats. Around the world, many different mooring maneuvers are used. In North Europe, sailors use the bow mooring, whereas in Mediterranean, stern to mooring is the standard practice. Here in the Mediterranean, the stern to mooring is more common, maybe because usually there is less wind, and so it's easier to maneuver by going backwards. Now it's a little windy, but we will see that following a few rules, we will be able to moor without problems.
La prima di queste.
The first rule is to arrive at the berth with the boat ready for mooring. That means to have the fenders at the side, the mooring lines coiled and ready to be tossed, and the boat hook ready to use.
La seconda regola.
The second rule to follow is speed. If we want to do a stern to mooring, we have to keep a slow speed. The less the wind, the slower we will proceed. And by proceeding slowly, we will always be able to maintain control of the boat. Whereas, if we speed up, the boat will move too fast and we will likely lose control.
Noi ne perderemo il controllo. Quando è che invece dobbiamo usare un pochino?
However, when the wind is strong, we will need to proceed a bit faster to counteract the wind.
Oggi c'è molto vento.
Today the wind is strong, 12-13 knots, but luckily it is blowing from the quay, so it's not a problem. On the contrary, it may even help us a bit when going upwind, because it acts as a brake. And now let's go to the berth and see what we need to do.
Ci stiamo avvicinando all'ormeggio.
We are approaching the berth and my colleague Alessandro, acting as our skipper today, has to decide where to start to turn the boat around. He is taking the boat to the berth, and when the bow is level with the berth, he will start rotating the boat until it is perpendicular or almost perpendicular to the quay.
Va a girare e si va a mettere sulla perpendicolare o quasi sulla perpendicolare del posto barca.
With this done, Alessandro can engage reverse gear and proceed towards the berth. Now, it's important to consider that we are using a boat equipped with an SO drive, because the propeller is located just aft of the keel and very far from the stern. For this reason, the boat is not affected by propeller work, and the rudder steers even if the propeller is rotating quite fast in reverse gear. This would not be possible on a boat equipped with a drive shaft.
Cosa che, per esempio, su un ormeggio con una barca in linea d'asse non si può fare.
When we reach the berth, it's important that someone is ready to toss the lines. Just before arriving at the berth, Alessandro disengages reverse gear and engages forward gear at a minimum idle. In this way, when it's time to stop the boat, he will not have to switch from reverse to forward gear. All he will need to do is open the throttle a little bit and the boat will be stopped. We also have to pay attention to the time between the stern line and lazy line attached to the mooring, because if we don't pay attention enough, the foredeck crew will have to work very hard. We need to toss the lines to the dock hand and keep them a bit slack. The helmsman opens the throttle a bit, moves the boat forward, and the foredeck crew can pick up the lazy line without effort and wrap it around the cleat. Then the helmsman reverses again and fastens the mooring line. The manoeuvre is accomplished.
La manovra è fatta. Abbiamo appena visto come ormeggiare una barca con l'S Drive.
We are now on a Sun Odyssey 54DS, so let's see how to moor a boat equipped with a drive shaft. The technique is considerably different because the propeller is set back, and this makes the walk effect particularly pronounced. In reverse gear, this right-handed propeller pushes the aft of the boat to the left.
Verso sinistra.
Alessandro now approaching the berth, but he will not try to put the boat at the right angle to the quay. He will keep it slightly offset, so that while he proceeds, the boat will line up with the quay. To obtain this effect, he engages reverse gear sharply, because the boat must build momentum. As long as the propeller is revved, the rudder will not respond well, but as soon as the propeller stops, the boat will become much more responsive and will start to steer. In other words, as long as the propeller rotates, the rudder cannot overcome the walking effect and the boat does not turn starboard or port. When the propeller has stopped, the rudder is able to steer the boat as effectively as it did with the NS drive and to arrive at the berth.
E riesce a entrare.
Once at the berth, Alessandro engages forward gear to be ready to stop the boat when needed. After reaching the quay, he stopped the boat by opening the throttle a little bit. Handles the lines in the same way as we have explained for the S drive boat, and the mooring is accomplished.
Che sono le stesse, può dire che l'ormeggio è fatto. Come abbiamo visto, ormeggiare.
As we have seen, mooring a boat is not so complicated. All we have to do is follow a few rules and pay some attention, and we are done. Now the lesson is over, so there is nothing left but to say goodbye, look forward to sharing our next Io Navigo lesson with you. And of course, thank North Sardinia Sail and Cala de Sardi for their assistance.